Hi, wrestling fans. Welcome to another exciting action-packed hour of Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Wrestling the way it used to be and the way you like it. I'm Bob Conlon, and we got a great hour in store for all you wrestling fans this week. We're going to see our long-awaited tag team title match with Jim Cornette's Heavenly Bodies as they defend the title against Ricky and Robert, the Rock and Roll Express. Also, we're going to see Killer Kyle in action. We'll have news on the Tim Horner Dirty White Boy situation and a grudge match with Dixie Dynamite taking on Paul Orndorff. And we'll have much, much more during this hour. Dutch, what's the signs?
Oh, nothing.
My tag partner right here, Dutch Mantell. Dutch?
First of all, we got more news on the Master, and my special guest today on Down and Dirty with Dutch will be the Commissioner of Smoky Mountain Wrestling, Bob Armstrong, with the latest news on the Master.
Fans, as we say, it's going to be a great, great hour right here on Smoky Mountain Wrestling. You don't want to go away. You want to stay with us during this entire hour because we've got some great wrestling in store for all the wrestling fans, Dutch. And as we said earlier,
coming over here for?
Yeah, well,
this is our time, Bob Dollar, not Ricky Morton's time.
Ricky Morton of the Rock and Roll Express. Rick, we just said this is what we've all been waiting for, that tag team title match.
That's right, Bob. You know, it's been a long, hard road for the Rock and Roll Express, but we finally got our match for the Smoky Mountain tag team titles. But I want to tell all the folks here something. Robert Gibson's mother is a deaf mute. So yesterday she went under surgery on her eyes. But Robert Gibson, I just called there. He's on his way back here flying into the Tri-City airports. He should be here later on, and I can't wait because, brother, the titles are on the line right here tonight, baby. Let's get it.
All right, fans, it's going to be a great one. And Dutch will be ready. We'll have the action right now. Let's go to the ring.
Here they come, Bob, your favorite team.
Well, there they are, Bobby and Jackie Fuller, of course, the fantastic, but they're just an outstanding tag team combination. Dutch, these guys, wherever they go, the fans love them. They always give you 110% of the ring. And I tell you, they're going to knock them in. There they are.
Ah, they ain't going to do nothing. Let's go back to the ring for Brian Matthews. I'll ring it out.
Their opponents tonight at a combined weight of 455 pounds from the City of Angels, Bobby and Jackie Fulton, the fantastic.
All right, Bobby and Jackie Fuller, the Fantastics.
I guess you think this team, the Fantastics, they're a pretty good team, right?
Well, I think they're an outstanding team. They've been together a long time. They think exactly alike. They know what the other guy's thinking. And that's exactly one of the things that you really need to be an outstanding tag team. Wait a minute. We've got the Stud Stable just moved in behind us here.
Robert Fuller and Jimmy Golden have joined us.
Yes, sir.
Gentlemen, it's a pleasure to see you out here, and I know you'd like to make some comments toward the Fantastics.
Sure would, Dutch. It's a pleasure to be with you. I don't know about this other guy out here, what his name is, but it's a pleasure to be with you. I want to talk about these Fantastics just a minute. These two guys that call themselves Fantastics are not fantastic. Me and Fuller's fantastic. These guys are losers. Me and Fuller has wore out a dozen set of knee pads apiece, down on our knees training to wrestle with these midgets just so that we can get back in contention for a title shot somewhere down the line. It's not working, I'm going to tell you right now. Smoky Mountain Wrestling has got everything all fouled up. We ought to be wearing the belts right
absolutely.
Now.
Absolutely. Robert, I know you've got some strong comments.
Wait a minute, Robert. I was just going to say, they look pretty sharp in that ring to me.
I don't want to hear none of your stuff. I'm here to talk to Doug. Doug, I want to tell you one thing, man. Me and Jimmy come up here and we realize that it is a bad place to be. We didn't care about being up here. We didn't want to be up here,
no. But
we decided we got a chance to see the guys we're fixing to wrestle. I realize they're handicapped. I realize that they have their own problems, but I'm going to guarantee you this, Dutch. Me and Jimmy are the guys to take care of them.
Well, what about the Smoky Mountain Wrestling is saying you guys have to fight your way back in contention? To me, that's wrong. You guys are top contenders. You're champions in your own right, and I don't think you need to have any kind of waiting list, especially on the same waiting list as the Fantastics.
You got it, Dutch. I said it right there. You know, I said, I'm sitting here and watching the handicapped. I'm watching some fellas that are dragging themselves up from behind. They're definitely losers. And at the same time, you're looking, oh, it's a double team move. They can't
even
get
the
win.
They can't
the Fantastics.
No, you cannot call that a win.
You got to call it a win. It was a 1-2-3.
It was a double team.
As we said, the Fantastics were looking great up there. I don't think they've ever looked sharper in a match. We can go back and watch
it. Okay, that's not a double team. That is a double team without a tag, I might add. He stood on the top rope, come off, and he gets a pin on his opponent there. The Fantastics, they're going to have a lot of trouble when they meet Fuller and Golden.
All right, and fans, stay tuned now. In the next segment, you're going to hear about an exciting new superstar coming to Smoky Mountain Wrestling.
You'd like to raise money for your school, club, or civic organization, and you'd like to see the excitement of Smoky Mountain Wrestling live in your hometown, this message is for you. High school and college athletic departments, sports teams, police and fire departments, JCs, civic groups, or any group wishing to raise money can bring the stars of Smoky Mountain Wrestling to town for a night of action and receive a portion of the receipt. Write to us or call Sandy Scott at 703-989-6819. Smoky Mountain Wrestling and your civic group, an unbeatable tag team.
Hey, Dutch, and you remember last week our program ended with another wild Donnybrook between the Dirty White Boy and White Lightning, Tim Horner. Fans, right now, let's go back and take another look at what happened.
The thing that Tim Horner can do is stay out of here and stay out of the way. Horner, watch out!
Tim Horner flying in at the Dirty White Boy, and he's attacked him. He's down on the floor. Dutch, look at this.
Well, he's got
on top of the
They're
Dirty
on the
white
floor
boy,
here.
Just pounding away at him. And Commissioner Bob Armstrong.
Get some help in the dressing room.
All right, and Commissioner Bob Armstrong says, hey, get some help out of the dressing room. This has got to stop, and we got to break it up as Horner is all after the white boy all around, Dutch.
Well, he's wrestling with a concussion against doctor's orders. I don't know what he's doing out here. Obviously.
It's a very dangerous situation for Tim
Horner. I think he's out of his mind. And a big, what was that? What did he hit White Boy with? He should be fine for doing that.
Fans, we're here right now with Mr. Ron Wright. Of course, he's the manager of the Smoky Mountain champion, the Dirty White Boy. And this situation with Tim Horner, looks like you guys have been trying to kill Tim Horner in the last few weeks.
No, Mr. Cottle, what's happening? I've been trying to keep my man off of Tim Horner. Tim Horner keeps coming out here and attacking me, an old man. Jumping on me out here when we're just out here doing nothing. I don't know what we're going to do. We're going to keep on. I'm going to turn him loose on him. Tell him, brother.
That's it. You know, last time on TV, you seen Tim Horner jump me from behind like a dog. You seen it and everybody else seen it. If he was here today and had one gut in his body, he'd come out here face to face, nose to nose. But you know what? I guess, Horner, your old lady's not letting you come out here because she knows that for one reason, if you showed up, then I'd beat your stinking ugly face in.
I have a woman to come out here and back the man.
Hey, here comes Tim Horner. Wait a minute, and the Dirty White Boy he's trying to get away. Wait a minute, he's got... Fans, we're going to be back. We got to go. We'll be back right after this. Wait a minute. Let's see. Tim Horner, come here. Let's see. Tim, we're still on. We managed to stay on. I thought he was going to jerk my microphone out of my hand there, but we're still on, Tim. And I know you wanted him. They really worked you over in the last couple of weeks.
You know, them two of the fastest talking guys I've ever seen, and it looks like their feet just a little faster than their mouth. I can't ever seem to keep up and get them right where I want them. One of these days, White Boy, you're going to pay the dues for hanging me, for busting the bottle over my head. Ron Wright, if you get in the way, I may hit him too.
All right, fans, we're going to be back. We're going to have more right after this.
Smoky Mountain Wrestling is bringing live professional wrestling to Eastern Kentucky to these towns. Harlan, Kentucky at the Kaywood High School, Friday, November the 13th at 8 p.m. Barberville, Kentucky, the Knox Central High School, Monday, November the 9th. Ronnie Garvin will be in Barberville. Also, Feds Creek, Kentucky, the Feds Creek High School, Friday, November the 6th, 8 p.m. The Rock and Roll Express will be in all these towns. And also, Paintsville, Kentucky at the Paintsville High School, Saturday, November the 7th at 8 p.m. Six big matches in Paintsville, including a Smoky Mountain title match. The Dirty White Boy defending against White Lightning Tim Horner.
You know, I've obviously got a lot of people wondering these days. Everybody's wondering, what's Tim Horner going to do in Paintsville when he gets in the ring with that Dirty White Boy? Well, I'm not going to tell you people in Paintsville, I'm not being disrespectful, but I don't want nobody to know what I'm doing to the dirty white boy. He's not even going to want to know. I want him to come down the streets of Paintsville looking over his shoulder, because I may jump him before he gets to Paintsville. And you better hope, dirty white boy, that volunteer fire department is there standing by to put your butt out when I get through kicking it.
Also in Paintsville, Paul Orndorff against Ronnie Garvin, and these guys, Ricky and Robert, the Rock and Roll Express against the Heavenly Bodies, and free pictures to the first 500 fans in Paintsville.
You know, Brian, that Jimmy Cornette and them Heavenly Bodies, they tried to end my career. They tried to mess up my hand real bad. Let me tell you something, Jimmy Cornette, it's going to be 110% right there. You better get your man ready.
That's right. Later on in the show, all the fans are going to see what happened that was taped a couple days earlier. But you see, Jimmy Cornette, throughout the history of the Rock and Roll Express, and you, Jimmy Cornette, well, I can say, you always try to do something to put us out of professional wrestling because you knew you could not face the fact that you could not beat the Rock and Roll Express. Well, I want to say one thing to all the fans here in Paintsville. You be ready and hold on tight, Jack, because it's time to explode like dynamite. You see, Jimmy Cornette, it's a stud stable that reunited the Rock and Roll Express. Now it's you, Jimmy Cornette, that's going to put us right back where we were before, right on top, because, baby, we're going to walk a mud hole on your behind, and then we're going to stomp it dry. Yeah, we don't care what it takes, right here in Paintsville. So all the fans, come on down. Rock and Roll Express is here to stay, not here to play.
Fans, right now we want to hear from one of the most exciting young men in wrestling, making his way now to Smoky Mountain Wrestling. It's the wild-eyed Southern boy, and are we glad to have him, Tracy Smothers. Let's hear from Tracy right now.
I'd like to thank Commissioner Bob Armstrong of Smoky Mountain Wrestling for giving me the opportunity to talk to the fans a little bit. Now, I got a little story to tell, and I'd like for y'all to sit back and just listen. All y'all know, for the past 2.5 years, I've competed in World Championship Wrestling out of Atlanta, Georgia. And y'all know, for the past year and a half, the side of the fence I've been on, well, I'd like to enlighten you on a little story here. When we first came in there, I was one half of the Wild-Eyed Southern Boys, and we signed a contract for more money than I've ever seen in my life. And man, we got in there and things were going good, and we come that close to being the United States Tag Team Champions, and even closer to being the World Tag Champions. After we'd been there about a year, I guess, some of the corporate people, the non-wrestling people, I might add, approached us and said, you know, guys, your outfits, you just don't look flashy enough, and we just don't really want that redneck country boy style, and you know, we would really like for you to change your name and maybe, you know, brighten that outfit up and get it, you know, get a nice shining outfit and be cowboys and take you away from that Southern boy. It just felt like they didn't like the fact that we were from the South and represented the South and what we stood for, and they wanted to change it altogether. And even where we're from, want us to say that we were from Cheyenne, Wyoming. Now, no offense to the folks that live out there in Wyoming. I've never been to Cheyenne, Wyoming, and I don't reckon I'll ever go. But, you know, we did that, changed our name to the Young Pistols, and, man, they started sending us to these towns up north, I'd never been up north before, and things are fast-paced, and folks up there are just ain't that good old Southern hospitality. And they didn't really like us, and to tell you the truth, we didn't really like them either. And when we started getting, man, we started getting bad vibes up north and even down south, people didn't understand. Why are y'all called the Young Pistols? Why are y'all not the Wild-Eyed Southern Boys, which we had been for the past 5 years? And we couldn't answer. You know, we couldn't answer. They said we had bought a ranch in Wyoming, in Cheyenne. I mean, come on. So pretty soon, we got all these bad vibes, people saying foul things. We started hollering back. We started forgetting where we came from. We started forgetting what got us to where we were at. And we started just, if you can't beat them, join them. And we changed our ways and just changed everything about us. Bullet Bob Armstrong called me one night. And he said, Tracy, he said, you know, you've been like a fifth son to me. He said, but you're headed down the wrong road. He said, right now, everything looks good. And I said, well, oh, yeah, everything looks good. I said, I'm one half the United States Tag Champions. What are you talking about? And he goes, yeah, it all looks great right now. He said, but remember this. He said, when you ride on that asphalt, you got a lot of riders with you. But once you run off in that mud, we'll see how many riders you got. Well, as you can see right now, I'm on my own, and I don't have any titles. And I'm going to tell you this. After a while, I started looking around and seeing what this was doing to me, and that I wasn't true to myself. I wasn't true to my family or my friends. And all the money in the world is not worth that. So I left that situation. And now I'm in Smoky Mountain Wrestling, which covers throughout all of East Tennessee, Eastern Kentucky, Virginia, and West Virginia. And I'm there. And wherever you see that logo, SMW, wrestling the way you like it, you will see the wild-eyed Southern boy, Tracy Smothers. And I'm going to do my dead-level best to show the millions of people out there watching this TV right now that I wasn't raised to be the type person that you saw the past year and a half. The old saying rings true. You can take the boy out of the country, but you can't take the country out of the boy. And these colors don't run. So wherever you see me, you will see the wild-eyed Southern boy. So remember this, and this is my motto, and it always will ring true. I'm American by birth. I'm Southern by the grace of God. I'll see you at the matches.
Wrestling fans, introducing first from Raleigh, North Carolina, 235 pounds, Robbie Eagle.
Wake up, rise and shine, you bunch of redneck hillbillies, and pay attention to the baddest man in the world, 305 pounds, from Hell's Kitchen, New York, Killer Kyle.
Killer Kyle is accompanied to the ring tonight by his manager, Mr. Jim Cornette.
All right, fans, and there he is, not only the mouth of the South, but the mouth of the world, Jim Cornette. And since he's taken over this man, he's been even more devastating in the ring. I'm talking about Wild Killer Kyle.
Well, he is a man that's going to have to be dealt with here in Smoky Mountain Wrestling. The man, the brains behind all this, of course, is the four-time manager, Jimmy Cornette, who is now joining us at the table. Jimmy, glad to see you.
Dutch, I tell you what, I'm never so happy in my life as when I come out here and I see all these genetic defects, because it makes me realize how lucky I was to have been born normal. I know what you've got to put up with out here, man, but I tell you what, I heard Ricky Morton whining and crying and complaining because he's cornered here. I think the whole thing smells like a plot.
Yes,
I think the whole thing smells like
Jim.
They're scared.
No.
What do you mean, no?
No, he said Robert's mother had an operation, and he's on his way. He's flying in, and they expect him any time.
Robert Gibson's mother had an operation, all right. She had an ugly transplant, and she had a whole lot to donate, I'll tell you that. You know something? It smells to me like they're scared. That's what the problem is. And look at my man, Killer Kyle. These dream matches, this November to remember, he's got a dream match coming up with the Hands of Stone, Ronnie Garvin. Well, I'll tell you something. We're going to see who the biggest and who the best street fighter is. I think I know that it's Killer Kyle. I just can't believe that the promoters are listening to the whims of the fans and letting them pick the matches. It's ridiculous. I don't know what else might come up for Killer Kyle of the Heavenly Bodies in the month of November.
Well, you know, this guy does look bigger every time we see him, Jim. I understand that you've been talking. I've heard some little rumors that you're talking about some kind of strength demonstration with this guy just to show how strong he really is.
That's exactly right. This is one of the strongest human beings I've ever seen in my life, man. He's a human monster. Nothing can stop him. Robbie Eagle, he don't have a chance right here. And I'll tell you something. Like I said, as far as the Rock and Roll Express goes, they're trying to make excuses. They're scared. But we got a contract, and I mean to have that title match today, because they really teed me off last week, man.
I guess you heard that, Bob Collins.
I heard
that. Great conversation, Jimmy.
Yeah.
Jimmy Cornette now making his way back to ringside just in time for the pin. There you see it, Bob Cottle. A big win there by Killer Kyle under the tutelage of four-time manager and my good friend, I might add, Jimmy Cornette. Now, let's take a look at it. All you munchkins in the truck out there, roll that back for all these fans at home. There you see Killer Kyle demonstrating some of the strength that Jimmy Cornette was just talking about. He puts Robbie Eagle down for the count, and I doubt very seriously if he's going to get up off that one. There you see the referee there. Flash Morris counting down. Jimmy Cornette very happy. And there you see Jimmy Cornette raising Killer Kyle's hand of victory. Let's go right now to Bob Cottle standing by with the Rock and Roll Express, Ricky Morton.
All right, and Dutch, right you are. And fans, here is Ricky Morton. Jim Cornette, he says there's some kind of a plot up. He doesn't believe this thing that Robert's on his way. And I know you want to just set everything straight for all the fans.
That's right. That's what I come here to say. Robert just called
He has landed already at the Tri-Cities Airport. He's in his car. He's on his way here. So, Cornette, don't get your hopes up. Rock and Roll's here, baby, and we're going to take those titles. All right?
All right, fans. That's going to be coming up later during this hour. You stay right with us. We'll be back. We'll have more right after we take this time out.
Now you can see the excitement of the Volunteer Slam in your own home. A one-night tournament to crown the first-ever Smoky Mountain champion is available on video cassette. The eight top stars of Smoky Mountain Wrestling are featured in seven great matches to decide who the best really is. To order your Volunteer Slam tape, send $15 plus $2 postage and handling to Smoky Mountain Wrestling, Post Office Box 1279, Morristown, Tennessee, zip code 37815, or write for a free merchandising catalog.
Welcome to Down and Dirty with Dutch. I'm Dutch Mantel, and you're not. And the views expressed on this segment are not necessarily those of this station or the staff of Smoky Mountain Wrestling, but they ought to be. Like I said before at the top of the program, my special guest today, Commissioner of Smoky Mountain Wrestling, Mr. Bob Armstrong, with some more news about the Master.
Well, if you'll remember last week, I promised the Master a chance to come on this program, speak his piece, talk to the fans, to me, to you, tell everybody what his problem is. I said I'd make that deal with him if he'd call off the Night Stalkers. Get him out of here, take the bounty off. If he'll do that, then I'll let him speak his piece. But so far, Dutch, I haven't heard anything from him. I haven't heard anything from him since then.
There's a letter, Mr. Armstrong, or a note.
All right, it's addressed to me, Commissioner Armstrong. It says, you were so kind to make your offer to me last week. My followers, the Night Stalker, and Malachi, the Grim Reaper, bring my greetings to you. They also bring a gift for Brian Lee and an offer. If Brian Lee wrestles and defeats the Night Stalker on next week's TV program, then I will appear in person the following week. However, I will not come merely to talk. I will appear only if I am allowed to face Brian Lee one-on-one in the ring. These are my terms. If you do not accept them, we will continue to meet like this. Well, I'll tell you, I'm ready to put a stop to the whole dadgum thing. Now, I don't know about him meeting the Master. I won't have any trouble booking a match with the Night Stalker for sure. But as far as him meeting the Master, I may have to go before the board because the Master has really disturbed the board of directors. They're very upset with him. And as far as I'm concerned, I don't know if I have the power to do that.
No. Okay, do you know who the Master is? Do you know anything about the Master?
I have no idea. All I know is I've been collecting these wanted posters for weeks. I collected 10 tonight. Brian Lee is upset. All his friends were upset.
But we're talking about Mr. Lee. He's on his way to ringside right now.
Hey, you let me interrupt 1 second.
Wait a minute. Brian Lee, 1967, 1990. Looks like a tombstone, Mr. Lee.
Well, I'll tell you what, one thing. I'm tired of this. This is sick. This isn't wrestling. This has been a dream of a lifetime to be a wrestler, and this is not wrestling, Dutch Mantel. And I'll tell you, Bob, they say Night Stalker, if I go through you next week, I get the Master. Well, it doesn't matter if I go through you right now, but I guarantee you one thing. Next week, I'm going through you, and Master arranged to see me.
Well, there you have it, fans. It looks like a grave situation to me. Hey, don't go away. We'll be right back in 2 minutes. Stay tuned. The title match between the Heavenly Bodies and the Rock and Roll Express coming up right after this.
You'd like to raise money for your school, club, or civic organization, and you'd like to see the excitement of Smoky Mountain Wrestling live in your hometown, this message is for you. High school and college athletic departments, sports teams, police and fire departments, JCs, civic groups, or any group wishing to raise money can bring the stars of Smoky Mountain Wrestling to town for a night of action and receive a portion of the receipt. Write to us or call Sandy Scott at 703-989-6819. Smoky Mountain Wrestling and your civic group, an unbeatable tag team.
All right, fans, with me right now here is Smoky Mountain Commissioner Bob Armstrong and, of course, Ricky Martin, Rock and Roll Rick.
You know, Bob, I kind of hate to come out here because I'm kind of embarrassed to say this right here, but I don't think Robert's going to be able to make the match tonight. I've come out here to ask Commissioner Bob Armstrong to see if we can postpone this match to next week because, you know, Robert had to go home. His mother had an operation. He had to come back. And, you know, it's running up, on time, but I want to see if I get this match postponed to next week.
Let me say this. I know Robert Gibson is always here on time. I've seen him warming up, getting ready for the matches time and time again.
Yes, sir.
And he'd be here if he could, and he may be here before it's over. But I'll tell you one thing. That's fine with me. The match will take place next week. I'll sign it right here. You've got your championship match. We'll make it next week, okay, Rick?
Thank you, Bob. Appreciate that very much.
Wait a minute. Here's Jim Cornette.
You watch out there. You keep him away from me. I got a contract. Shut up, you defects. I got a contract right here for a tag team title match that you went to the ends of the earth to get. Well, you got it, and it's got today's date on it. Not next week, not next month, not next year. You ain't got a partner, that ain't my problem. If you want a match for the belt, same one I signed last week, you nut. If you want a match for the belts, then you better produce a partner today or you're going to forfeit, because I'm holding you to the contract that you signed just like I did, brother. Today or never.
I'm sorry, the contract's legal. I signed it. You know, you asked me to sign it. We signed it. So I guess it's going to have to be a legal contract.
Oh, my God. Okay. Thank you, Bobby.
All right, and I hope Rick's able to come up with a partner. Fans, don't, this is not over. This is going to continue. We're going to try to get something worked out, I'm sure, before this hour is over. You know, the situation between Ronnie Garvin and Paul Orndorff was pretty funny at first. That's when Garvin got the robe, and he kept cutting it off, but it really got ugly last week when Orndorff took out his frustrations on Nitro Danny Davis. So right now, fans, let's go back. Let's take a look at what happened right here last week. Well, Mike Sampson goes down here.
Wait a minute.
He's going to pile drive him. He's got him up for the pile driver. Orndorff with Nitro Danny Davis, and he does it.
What a pile driver on Danny Davis.
Paul Orndorff with the illegal pile driver.
Ronnie Garvin, the process of elimination has just begun.
Come here.
Danny Davis, I hope I just broke your neck. Ronnie Garvin, you're gonna be next. Ronnie Garvin, Ronnie Garvin, you will be next.
Please. Oh, God.
Come on, man. You'll be all right.
All right, fans, with me right now, Dixie Dynamite, and here's the man with the hands of stone, Ronnie Garvin. Ronnie, we said it was sort of funny, that robe that was Paul Orndorff's. It's a little funny now on you, cut off like that, but it got really dirty and nasty for Nitro Danny Davis last week.
That's right. I'm going to tell you, it goes to show you that from the beginning I was right talking about Paul Orndorff, what extent he'll go. He don't care if he has to cripple people like Danny Davis. Well, I've called his family, and they told me that he was going to be okay, maybe a month or two, but he's got a brace around his neck, and he's lucky that it didn't break his neck. It was very close to it. Paul Orndorff, you want to go to the extent of crippling people and putting them out of wrestling? Well, you're going to have to deal with me. I feel responsible for what happened to Danny Davis for the simple reason because he's been behind me, he's been helping me. He's been watching my back because Paul Orndorff has been known to ask help from other guys. And Danny Davis is a true friend of mine, and he stands by me. And Danny Davis, I'm going to make Paul Orndorff pay for what he did. And this gentleman here probably will start right tonight.
Well, a close friend and, of course, a partner, Nitro Danny Davis, Dixie Dynamite. Dixie?
That's exactly right. You know, Danny Davis has been my partner on many occasions, and I saw what happened. And I saw all the people in the building, they were chanting, Paula, Paula. So you hear them right now, Bob Cottle. Well, tonight, brother, it's me and it's you, Paula, and I'm going to be coming at you all the way live. You will see stars.
All right, fans, that match will be coming up when we come back, right after we take this brief time out.
Now you can see the excitement of the Volunteer Slam in your own home. A one-night tournament to crown the first-ever Smoky Mountain champion is available on video cassette. The eight top stars of Smoky Mountain Wrestling are featured in seven great matches to decide who the best really is. To order your volunteer slam tape, send $15 plus $2 postage and handling to Smoky Mountain Wrestling, Post Office Box 1279, Morristown, Tennessee, zip code 37815, or write for a free merchandising catalog.
Fans, the most exciting events at Smoky Mountain Wrestling so far, the Thanksgiving Thunder Tour, are coming Thanksgiving weekend to selected cities. The feature event of this series is the Pick the Winner Battle Royal, a match in which one of the fans in attendance could be the winner. When you enter the arena on the night of the event, you will see a table with boxes, one for each man in the Battle Royal. Simply write your name and address on a piece of paper and place it in the box of the man you think will win the Battle Royal. When the match is over, the winner's box will be brought to the ring and one name will be drawn. That lucky fan will be named the winner of the Pick the Winner Battle Royal and receive a lifetime pass to all Smoky Mountain Wrestling events, as well as a great prize such as a 20-inch colored television, a video cassette recorder, and more. A different prize in each city on the tour. So don't miss the Pick the Winner Battle Royal, part of Thanksgiving Thunder, coming Thanksgiving weekend to a town near you.
Wrestling fans, introducing first, from the heart of the Confederacy, 216 pounds, Dixie Dynamite. His opponent tonight is from Atlanta, Georgia, 250 pounds, Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff.
All right, fans, and we're about ready now with action in the ring. And Duchess, wait a minute.
Tell him, Paul.
Yeah, Paul.
Is this on? Let me tell you something right now. Ronnie Garvin, until I give my robe back, I'm going to stick every one of your friends like, what's his name? Danny Davis. I'm going to stick every one of them like Danny Davis, and they're going to be out of professional wrestling. I'd better give my ring back one way or the other.
All right, Dutch, there's a warning if you ever heard it right there. He just said, and until he gets his robe back, he's going to take out every single one of the friends. And the man with a hand of stone, Ronnie Garvin.
Well, I'm talking from experience right here. When Paul, Mr. Wonderful Orndorff, says something, you can bank on it. And if he says he's going to take some people out, that's exactly what he's going to do. I can't understand these people in the crowd here in this stinking state of Virginia calling a man of the stature of Paul Orndorff, calling him by a feminine name, Paula.
Well,
now, look there. Look
well,
at Dixie
Dynamite. Behind, Dixie Dynamite tapped him on the shoulders when he turned around. He met all five of them in the form of a fist right under the jaw. And Orndorff staggering and reeling around the ring. This one may be over in a hurry.
No, I don't think it may
go the way that Paul Orndorff wants it to. Irish whip. What about that dropkick, Dutch?
Well, what Dixie Dynamite did, he attacked him while his back was turned. He's a backfighter. He's a cheater like his friend Danny Davis, and we all know what happened to him. And just the same fate may await Dixie Dynamite. Come on, Mr. Wonderful, kick!
And good. A count of two, and he kicked out of there. Dixie Dynamite right now using his athletic ability and his agility to really work over Paul Orndorff, but the big, strong Orndorff has begun to turn the tables right here.
Good move.
We just saw some information on the Pick the Winner Battle Royal, one of the feature events on the Great Thanksgiving Thunder Tour coming up November 26th to the 29th. And you want to keep watching for more details on this great event.
Okay, fans, watch very intent here. Let's watch Paul Orndorff methodically take apart Dixie Dynamite.
He doesn't get
in a hurry. He does it very methodical. And he's going to pick him apart piece by piece. My question to you, Bob, and I'm trying to get the cameraman's attention here, has Robert Gibson ever physically entered the building yet? Is he here? Is he going to be with Ricky Morton?
I have not heard.
There's something that's fishy here. Like Cornett said a little earlier, there's something fishy about Robert Gibson not being here. I just can't quite figure out.
I think Ricky Morton told me exactly what the way it was, and I think that's what he was doing. Orndorff right here.
We'll see in our next segment right here.
In his power, he was able to block that move right there by Dixie Dynamite. You know, this match, Dutch, really means a lot to this young man. It's a chance for him to get some revenge for his friend and his tag partner, Nitro Danny Davis, and I'm sure that Danny Davis is at home. He's going to be watching this match, and he's certainly pulling for his young friend.
Well, he should be at home where he should have been last time he got the ring of Paul Orndorff. He should have been home then he could have saved himself a big injury. Now, Dixie Dynamite, I don't think he's in the ring trying to avenge his wonderful friend, Nitro Danny Davis. He better be worried about his own house. When you're in the ring with Paul Orndorff, you're in there with a man who's been a phenomenal success in his profession and continues to do so. He is a legend in his own right. And I think right now, Dixie Dynamite is finding out firsthand exactly what it's like to go against a world-class wrestler like Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff.
Yeah, Mr. Wonderful Orndorff, as you said, he got that knee right under the midsection. And I tell you, when he gets you hurt, fans, he's going to be right back on the attack, just like he was with that knee right to the side of the jaw of Dixie Dynamite, who is down to the mat.
Now,
punishment land when Paul Orndorff's above you.
I just hope that Dixie Dynamite doesn't start crying and begging and saying, please, Mr. Wonderful, let me go back to the division. He cries all the time. Why is the commissioner, Bob Armstrong? He's the biggest crybaby in Smoky Mountain Wrestling.
You know, Dutch, I just checked while you were talking there.
Look, another move from the back.
Counted two, and he almost had it pinned. I checked it. Robert Gibson still has not arrived, and we'll find out.
He's not going
to
arrive.
In that title match
fans, he ain't showing up. He's afraid. Wait a minute. Now, look.
There's Garvin down at ringside, and he's got that robe of Orndorff. Orndorff about to get Dynamite up into a position for the pile driver. And he looks over, and he sees Garvin there with that robe.
Now, why is Garvin doing this?
He's going to lose it all right here. Look at Orndorff. He just drops sticks of Dynamite, takes off after.
Now, look. Garvin is running
Mr.
like
Garvin
the lowlife
right
egg sucking.
The ring.
He's running. He's a coward. Look at him.
He's just making fun of Orndorff. He turns around to taunt him, and around the ring they go.
The referee is counting. Flash my. What?
The referee said ring the bell.
No.
Yes, sir. He counted out for Orndorff.
Count out Dixie Dynamite.
No.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Where is the commissioner now that you need?
Well, he was outside the ring. He was counted out. In any doubt about that, he was counted out at a count of 10, and the winner, Dixie Dynamite. Don't forget, fans, you just saw Ronnie Garvin there. Next week, our first free match, Ronnie Garvin against Killer Kyle. Right now, let's take time out for this.
Wrestling fans, Smoky Mountain Wrestling is bringing live professional wrestling to these towns in eastern Kentucky. Harlan, Kentucky at the Kentwood High School Friday, November the 13th at 8 p.m. Barberville, Kentucky at the Knox Central High School Monday, November the 9th at 8 p.m. Ronnie Garvin will be in Barberville. Also, Feds Creek, Kentucky at the Feds Creek High School Friday, November the 6th at 8 p.m. The Rock and Roll Express will be in all of these towns. And also, Smoky Mountain Wrestling in Paintsville, Kentucky at the Paintsville High School Saturday, November the 7th, 8 p.m. Six big matches, Paul Orndorff against Ronnie Garvin, and also in Paintsville, a Smoky Mountain title match with the Dirty White Boy defending against White Lightning Tim Horner.
Paintsville? Get ready, baby. It's getting closer and closer. It's getting real close. Rush right out and buy your tickets, because you're going to see the end of White Lightning Tim Horner. Because, Horner, you've been a thorn in my side. You've bothered poor old Mr. Wright. The man is still in the home. He's sick, and what do? You keep calling him and calling him. Give me a title shot. Give me a title shot. Well, you've got it in Paintsville, buddy. And when I walk out aisle, there's only going to be one man walk out, and you're looking at him, the heavyweight champion.
Also in Paintsville, the Rock and Roll Express against the Heavenly Bodies managed by Jim Cornette, and free pictures to the first 500 fans.
Give them everything. Go ahead, bring some food. Bring some canned food. Yeah, everybody bring some canned food down there to Paintsville High School, just like every other one of the welfare cases. Give them some canned food. Give them some Spam. Give them something to take home. I'll tell you what we're going to give the Rock and Roll Express. You better take one of those letters out of the name of Paintsville. Shouldn't be hard. You don't know how to spell up there anyway in eastern Kentucky. Take that T out, and it's going to become Painsville. Because that's what you're in for, Rock and Roll Express, a whole lot of pain. This is personal. That's exactly right. Has been with me in the rock and roll for a long time. Stan Lane and Tom Pritchard, the Heavenly Bodies, the first time Paintsville seen real men in a long time, is going to be November the 7th, brother. Don't miss it.
All right, fans, with me right now, Ricky Moore. And Ricky, last word I had was that Robert still had not arrived. Is that right?
Well, Bob, you know, sometimes things happen that you have no control over. At this moment right now, Robert Gibson hadn't showed up. It looked like I'm going to have to forfeit the match that we worked so hard for. But, you know, sometimes things just like that happen. You know, he landed in the Tri-City Airport. He hadn't got here yet. It's time for the match. And you know how Jimmy Cornette, look coming here. Here he comes.
Here comes Jim Cornette and the Heavenly Body. What?
You know what?
No.
Hey. Man, let me tell you what's going on here, brother. Let me tell you what's happened. Your partner has suckered you. Your partner has done the same thing to you that you did to him a couple of years ago. He's left you standing out in front of a bunch of people like a blithering idiot. And I love it. I've been waiting a long time to see you made a fool out of like this, because you see, just like you said when you came back to Smoky Mountain Wrestling, brother, you've lost everything in your stinking life. You lost your house, you lost your car, you lost your family, you lost your friends, you lost your fans, all because of the way you were acting, and now you have lost your partner who finally got a chance to get even with you. And you know what that makes you, Ricky Morton? A habitual, chronic loser. And I've been waiting since 1984 to look you in the eye and have my boys wearing tag team belts, and we're ready to wrestle, and you ain't got no partner, and you can't get in the ring, and like I said, you ain't got no friends, no family. They don't care nothing about you. They're a bunch of blithering idiots, too. The only person in the world that'll even talk to you is your stinking daddy, Paul Morton, over there in Nashville, and the only reason that he speaks to you is because he's so drunk all the time he don't know who you are.
Oh, well, let me tell you something, buddy. You don't talk about my family, and I'll be damned if you won't get away with this at a fight. Come on.
All right, and Morton says, go to the ring, by golly. And he goes charging in, Doug.
Well, Bob, I'll have to say, I think Ricky Morton made a severe mistake last night by taking Jimmy Cornette. He's outnumbered, and he's all by himself.
Cornette went down, and down goes also Dr. Tom Pritchard and Stan Lane. And Morton is fired up. He don't care how many's in there right now, Dutch. Now he's going to take them all on. Even Killer Kyle, who's outside the ring. Cornette's about to have a conniption outside.
Well, I think Ricky Morton is just delaying the inevitable here, because I don't think he can handle two men. Well, he's by himself. He's fighting an down under battle here. And who knows where Robert Gibson is. He may be off drunk somewhere
Gibson somewhere. Doesn't drink, and I know that's not the case. We've had the tag. Pritchard goes out. Lane comes in. Lane with the arm drag. He goes down. So far, it's been all Ricky Morton. He's taken them both on Dutch, and he's done very well. It's been all offense on his part.
Well, let's see how long he can keep it up. He's going to have to keep it up.
What a fantastic feather it would be in his hand if he would take on both of the heavenly bodies and defeat them.
Well, yeah, it would. But see, if is a middle word in life, and he's not going to do it.
Well, down goes Lane from that block coming off of the ropes.
You watch right now.
Ropes again, and another hip toss. Down he goes. Pritchard runs right into a big right hand. So far, it's still all Ricky Morton.
Well, first of all, Ricky Morton is wrestling strictly on adrenaline. The adrenaline's flowing. He's all pumped up. He's energized. But he's going to get tired here, because one guy cannot handle two guys.
Well, this is sure Jim Cornette's dream match, no doubt. He didn't have to wait until November to remember that.
I know these things. That's what I get paid to know. I know these things. Ricky Morton, he may have a couple of minutes left in him, and then that energy level is going to drain. And when he drains, he's in serious trouble. He may have put his career in jeopardy right here today.
Well, you could be right. The bodies may make good on their pledge to put Rock and Roll Light right here tonight, right here at the Smoky Mountain. And Pritchard goes standing together.
You know what?
Heads come together and meet in a hard collision right over near the corner. They both go down.
You know what I can't believe? I can't believe Ricky Morton is so stupid. Try to wrestle both these men by himself. He should have just stepped aside and said, hey, another day, guys. But another thing I can't believe is why he tried to weasel his way out of it by making some bogus excuse that Robert Gibson somewhere.
That's not right. He didn't try to weasel out of it.
I
agree with you on one point. He let his anger get the better of him right here. He should not have done that.
We agree on that.
That's the only point we agree on so far, Dutch. Here's a tag from the Heavenly Body.
Look, he's running.
He just got out of that corner.
No, he's
that
running.
That was no man's land. He
he's
had to get out of there.
He's a chicken like Ronnie Garvin is a chicken from running from Paul Orndorff. Now he's running from the Heavenly Body. What kind of wrestlers are these guys if they want the fans to support them, but the fans are supporting a bunch of low-life, egg-sucking dogs, chickens, cowards, Have I made myself
How
clear?
How can you say the guy is a coward, Dutch, when he's in there against two guys that are the tag team champions? Not only that, they've got their manager outside of the ring, and he's got standing behind him, backing him up, a great big giant, a quiet man that nobody's ever gotten a word out of. Probably the strongest man that you or I even know
I've
of
had,
anywhere.
I've had a lot Killer of conversations Kyle, right with Killer Kyle.
Oh, you have?
Yes,
can he
I
talk?
Have. Yes, he can. He's a very intelligent man like I am. Bob, you wouldn't understand what he's talking about because of your intelligence level, but I do. Now, Ricky Morton, I hate a smart mouth like Ricky Morton. He gets in there and bumps those guns. He talks a big game, but when it comes time to back it up,
he's certainly backing it up now as he went right high over the head of Richard and came back with a monkey flip.
Well, he's doing all kind of acrobatic moves in the ring, but see, the more he does, the tighter he's going to get. He's not wrestling a very smart match anyway. Now, if it was me, I'd have no problem. Lane, he does. He has a problem.
Look at Lane there. Let's make a point here that Lane, when the crowd starts hollering and yelling, puts his hand up to those ears again. And again, he's wearing that, whatever that guard is over his ear. I still think that ear should be healed by now. Here goes Pitcher through the rope. Now he's in trouble. Cornette.
What did I tell you, Bob? He's going to be in trouble. And he is in serious trouble now.
Slammed to the ring post right there by Tom Pritchard. And Cornette, with that tennis racket held high above his head, starts what probably for him is a little victory dance. What are they going to do with him right here? Pritchard looks like he's getting in. Hard right hand.
What Tom the Doc is doing to Ricky Morton now is just giving him some individual attention.
Well, he had him measured for that right, and there's another one. Dutchie just measures him off, gets all of his power and all of his strength behind those blows, and Morton right now completely defensive.
Now,
going back into the ring by Tom Pritchard.
A man in Ricky Morton's position right now is in serious trouble, serious jeopardy of keeping his career being either thwarted, hindered, or possibly a permanent injury can result from this. I know he wants to stand up and be a man, but see, to be a man, you got to have the guts of a man, and Ricky Morton doesn't have the guts of a man. He was running just a few
guts,
minutes ago.
How can you say guts when he's in against two? You might even say four when you count Cornette and Kyle.
How can I say that?
Yes, sir.
Easy. I just said it. He has no guts.
All the
he
guts
has
in
no
the
guts.
World.
Ricky Morton, okay, I'm going to say it again. Ricky Morton has no guts. He's stupid.
Man.
He's an idiot.
Yeah, right now he's dragged over to the corner, and here's the tag.
That's the key word, dragged over, because he can't walk over to beat him down too much.
Double team coming off of the ring.
Now they got
him. They both got a head around the throat.
Now the referee needs to get one man out.
Back to the corner now. Morton's trying to fight his way out. There's another good hard run.
And he found a little bit of a second wind there.
Up. He's backing him up and into the corner. Puts him all the way across the ring, hard to the turnbuckle.
Power slam.
Scooped him up for the power slam, Dutch.
Okay, Cornette calling for the pin.
Oh, the count of two, and he kicked out.
Referee Mark Curtis down with a count of two.
Cornette said it was too slow. He sure thought it should have been three.
It was a little slow.
Now you talk about Dutch. It took a second for Morton to get out of that and come back up to take more punishment.
No, they held him. If Ricky Morton had his options here, he'd leave the ring like he tried to do a while ago.
This is Stan Lane again as he scoops up Morton. Power slams him hard to the mat.
I would like to know
tag. They're going to get a double team off of him here off of that tag.
I'm going to check into this situation. I'm going to find out where Robert Gibson is. Next week, probably. It's only a matter of time now for Ricky Morton.
And two, and they lift him up. They could have pinned him, and wait a minute,
watch
Cornette.
This Cornette's on his way over
no.
here.
It's great to have him in this position for a long time. We're going to punish him all the way to the end of the mat.
They're going to punish him all the way, he said. They've been waiting for this. As they scoop him up, slam him to the mat again.
Good strategy. What you're seeing here is a culmination of about 7 or 8 years of bad blood. They have waited, like Jimmy Cornette just said, 7 or 8 years to get one of the Rock and Roll Express in a position where they can really punish him for all the anguish and all the grief that he has caused Jimmy Cornette over the years.
That, Dutch, there's no doubt. And you just saw, wait a minute. Here comes Robin Gibson charging into the arena in his street clothes.
He must have just got here.
He just came into the building. And he goes
he
in
going?
Under
he came
the
from,
heavenly bodies, both of them.
He came from the front door. I believe. I think he just pulled up out front.
He did.
But he's into the ring now.
That's exactly what happened to him. There's Pritchard.
But now, where's Ricky Morton? Ricky Morton is down from having absorbed so much punishment. Watch out,
Here's
Gibson.
Cornette.
Wait a minute. He's got
Cornette. Go down.
Cornette's down.
He's got Cornette.
Oh, a big punch by Gibson on Cornette. Cornette's down. uncalled for.
Well, he had no business in the ring. Certainly
he wasn't in the ring. Gibson pulled him in the ring.
Him again. Now Gibson's going to be triple teamed. Cornette in there trying to throw some punches as are both of the heavenly bodies. They got Gibson in the corner. Morton on his hands and knees.
Cornette's racket went flying. He's got the racket.
Morton has got it.
Oh!
There's one to Pritchard.
Pritchard is stunned from that racket.
Here comes Killer Kyle. Oh, we got complete bedlam, and we've lost it all here now, Dutch. The referee said ring the bell. The bell is sounded, but nobody's paying any attention to it.
Now, Kyle, he's doing a number on
Rock. Here goes the referee out of the ring. Shot right out by Cornette, and Cornette says, give it to him, work him over. Do it all and do whatever you can. Now it's Gibson down who's being stomped and kicked.
Okay, both the Rock and Roll are down. Here comes some help to the ring, it looks like. Robbie Eagle coming to the ring. He gets mad with a punch
out
for his trouble from Killer Kyle. He's down back on the mat. Here comes another guy, Mike Sampson, I think, coming to the ring.
Well, and Sampson kicked by Cornette.
Wait a minute. Here comes another one. Who's in? Paul Lee trying to help out. It's not going to do any good,
guys. Well, three guys come charging in the ring, and nobody been able to get in.
Too much bad blood going on here for anybody to interfere with it. These guys should stay out of it. It's none of their business. And right now, Ricky Martin is down.
They're definitely Dutch are trying to put the Rock and Roll out for good. What are they doing?
They're
just stomping at the hand. Look at them stomping at the hand.
We've got to get out of here, Bob.
Fans, don't forget, next week we'll see a challenge match. It's Ryan Lee taking on a man known as the Night Stalker as they continue to really work on the hand now, Gibson.